Alright, a barrier that only lets players of a certain team walk through and blocks players on the other teams. Before we start, make sure you have your team set up and also create the part that you want to act as your barrier. In my example, I have a red team and a blue team. My barrier part will only let red team players through. Make sure the can collide is enabled on the part because we still want the part to collide with the players on the other teams in order to block them. The first step is to go to the model tab at the top and open up the collision groups editor in the advanced section. Click the add group button, type in the exact name of one of your teams, and then press enter to confirm. Create a corresponding collision group for each team you have in your game. Select each collision group you have created and uncheck the box with the same name. So for the red collision group, uncheck the checkbox labeled red. This will make it so that parts assigned to the red collision group do not collide with each other. We will use a script to change a player's character collision groups soon. Select your barrier part in the viewport, and in the collision groups editor, select the collision group corresponding to the team that you want to be able to pass through. So for my red barrier, I will select the red collision group. Click the plus button to assign the collision group to the barrier part. Now we need to make a script to assign the parts of each player's character model to their team's collision group. So create a new script in server script service. First, we need to detect when a player joins the game by using player added, and we pass in the player object in the function. Then we detect when the player's character model loads in, and we pass in the character object in this function. We'll loop through each of the character's descendants and check if it is a base part. A base part is capable of collisions and can have a collision group assigned to it. So if that is the case, then we set that part's collision group to the player's team name. Once again, this is why the collision groups you have made previously have to have the exact same name as your teams. The barrier part's collision groups and the player's collision groups have to match exactly. Make sure to check your capitalization, of course. What if later on the player's team is changed by another script? Well, we can use getPropertyChanged to signal to detect when the team property of the player changes, and we basically just copy the code above to reassign the collision groups. The character in the for loop definition is not defined here because it's not passed in from an event, so we have to replace it with player.character. Make sure to capitalize the C. Okay, so that's all you need to do. The code is in the description if you need it. Okay, let's see if it works. I'm on red team right now, so I'm able to pass through. If I set myself to blue team, you can see now I'm being blocked. So that's how you can make a team barrier in Roblox. I hope this video helped.